Well, Roseville has a new night spot getting ready to open for business.
Yeah, that's right. And KCR3's Mapus Eye is out on a project economy report for us this morning, taking a look at a new business called the Sucky House. And it has some familiar names attached to it.
Well, guys, this is something you're never going to see. Mapus Eye cooking in action here at the Sucky House at the Fountains at Roseville. This is really cool. It's nice to see new businesses open up when we're seeing so many fold and fall apart. But they just opened up last night, and check us out. This is Lee Dow. He's with me. He's the kitchen manager here. You guys had a big night last night,
we
right?
We had a fantastic night last
700
night.
700 people?
700 heads. Actually, we think it's actually more than that.
Wow. So, yeah. Okay. Well, one of the big attractions is you guys have some rolls that we don't normally see, and we are going to make one of them. This is called the Spicy Stacy, but when we're done here, it's going to be called the Spicy May, okay? So this is spicy tuna we have here, right?
Okay, and we also have a little bit of cucumber there.
All right.
So what we're just going to do here is get a little water in our hands.
Okay.
And we're going to use your thumbs here just to fold it over. Right?
Is this really, really spicy?
So it's not too spicy at all. I'd call it like a 6 out of 10. Okay, so once you roll it over, you want to tuck it in.
Okay.
That's what gets it nice and...
Well, mine's a little bit of a bigger roll.
Hey, you're a hungry girl, right?
Okay.
All right. The next, we're going to put a little bit of a sea bass on top of there.
So one thing that I really like is when a fish is really fresh. So that's important for you.
Yes.
Here,
it's also very important that you know where you're getting your fish from.
Now, we know that having new hot rolls is a way to attract clientele. But what else do you think is makes your business so successful?
You know, it's for me, it's pleasing the traditional eaters and also the new eaters where they like, you know, fusion types of food, but then also you got to make sure that you can satisfy the taste of traditional sushi eaters also. So keeping nice and fresh fish, make sure your techniques are correct.
Well, I'm going to let you continue on, and I'm going to go over because there's a lot more here at Sucky House. There's also really cool drinks like sake tini to kind of pair with your stuff. This is Erin Miller. She's a bartender here. We have sake tinis in lemon and cucumber.
Yes, we have a cucumber sake tini and a lemon sake drop.
The drop is probably more of a dessert, kind of, right? Okay.
Yeah.
And then you guys also have other things going here, like dancing. Rightly, tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, we got a nightclub aspect of the whole restaurant. So, you know, after 10 o'clock, from Wednesday through Saturday, we do a little nightclub. We have great DJs.
You got some cool bosses too, right?
We have awesome bosses. They're like the new, you know, young, hip guys.
Tell us a little bit about your bosses because they're kind of big in the community.
Well,
we've
got Randy Paragary, of course, and we have Bob Simpson. You know, Paragary's restaurants, and Bob owns Empire and Social and a few other clubs out there.
Well, that knife looks a little sharp, so I'm going to let you cut mine up too. And then, I'm going to taste this a little bit here, guys. Let's see.
You can't say anything.
Yeah. Thank you.
That's us. Very
good
cool.
Stuff.
Thank you, Meg.
All right. Well, let me take care of your role here.
It's going to be a great spot. Hop in over there in the Fountains.
She's not back anytime soon. We'll know why.